Next question, 9th question. A liquid flowing in a pipe has a head loss of 2 meters in a pipe length of 10 meters. The Reynolds number of the flow is 100. If the flow rate is doubled, if the flow rate is doubled and all other fluid properties remain the same, the head loss in meters is A, 0.5, B, 8, C, 4, D, 2. Now the head loss formula HF is equal to delta P by W, that is head loss due to friction, is given by 32 mu V L by W d square or 128 mu Q L by pi W d to the power of 4. Therefore, if the flow rate is doubled, that is HF is directly proportional to the Q, and all other fluid properties remains the same, that is density, dynamic viscosity, etc., the head loss in meters is, flow rate is doubled means head loss is also gets doubled. Answer will be 4 meters. For a length of 10 meters and discharge of Q, it is 2 meters. If the Q is doubled, obviously the head loss also becomes doubled. Since Q is doubled, HF also gets doubled. Answer is C. Next question. Tenth question. The minimum value of friction factor that can occur in laminar flow through a circular pipe is A, 0.025, B, 0, C, 0.064, D, 0.032. the flow is laminar as long as Reynolds number is less than 2000 for flow through pipes. Of course, it is only for flow through pipes, that is circular pipes. If V is the velocity, D is the diameter, and rho is the density, and mu is the dynamic viscosity, then Vd rho by mu should be less than 2000, then the flow is said to be laminar. So also in laminar flow through pipes, F is equal to friction factor is equal to 64 by Re, implies F is 64 by 2000. If you keep, you get the minimum friction factor for flow to be laminar. Because we have substituted the maximum value of the Reynolds number possible for the flow to be laminar. I have substituted 2000, the maximum Reynolds number value for flow to be laminar. Obviously, we would get minimum friction factor F. Next question. In a circular tube of radius R carrying laminar flow, the ratio of average velocity to the maximum velocity in the conduit is A 0.50, B 1.00, C 0.67, D 0.33. In laminar flow, mean velocity or average velocity is half of V max. That is, V max would happen at the center line. If this is the velocity distribution, V max would occur at the center line. The average velocity of flow will be half of the mean velocity. Average velocity of flow is double the mean velocity. The answer is A. Average velocity is half of the maximum velocity at the center line. Now I shall define momentum correction factor. Beta. Earlier we had defined kinetic energy correction factor alpha. If you consider the flow through pipes, a two-dimensional flow is the one which has got velocity is changing in both y and x directions. In the two-dimensional transition shown in figure, the velocity distribution of u, where u is the velocity, and D is the diameter. The velocity distribution of U with Y, this is X direction, this is Y direction, is accounted for by taking average velocity V is equal to this is B I have taken, it's rather than D I would like to take as a B is a distance between the top and bottom plates, 1 by B integral U dy. The momentum correction factor beta is equal to 1 by V square into area flow integral U square dA. In fact, this momentum correction factor will take into account the variation of velocity in the Y direction, which is a normal direction to the direction of flow. The flow is along the X direction, but the velocity is also changing with reference to the Y direction. Here V is taken as the average velocity, A is the area of flow. If it is a pipe, the area of flow will be pi by 4 d square. This beta is accounted for calculating momentum flux. Momentum flux at any section is m into beta rho q v, where v is the average velocity at that section. In laminar flow through a circular tube, beta is equal to 1.33, and for turbulent flow through pipes, beta is equal to 1.05. In fact, the momentum correction factor beta will take into account the variation of U with respect to Y direction and the resultant variation in the momentum flux. Momentum is defined as mass into velocity. Rate of momentum or momentum flux is mass into velocity divided by time. Mass by time is called as mass flow rate. Therefore, momentum flux is equal to mass flow rate into velocity, that is mass into velocity divided by time. The mass flow rate can be written as rho q. So, momentum flux is equal to rho q into velocity, which has got the units of Newton. Because the velocity is taken into variation with respect to y direction, let us introduce the momentum correction factor beta, which when multiplied with rho qv, that will give the correct value of the momentum flux at any given cross section. For laminar flow it is 1.33, for turbulent flow it is 1.05. Next question, objective question, what I take is, in a laminar flow through a circular pipe, of 12 centimeters diameter, the center line velocity is (2.0 meters per second). At a radial distance of 2 centimeters from the pipe axis, the velocity is A, 0.222 meters per second, 1.333 meters per second, 1.778 meters per second, D, 1.667 meters per second. The solution to the problem is given like this. The velocity distribution at a cross section in laminar flow through pipes is parabolic. If Vmax is the center line and U is the velocity at any radius r, U by Vmax is equal to 1 minus r by r whole square. This is the velocity distribution where capital R is the radius of the pipe. So, with this velocity distribution, which is a parabolic distribution of velocity, we can substitute the values. That is, center line velocity Vmax is given as 2, capital R is 6 centimeters because that is 12 divided by 2. And small r is given as 2 centimeters, implies U is equal to Vmax into 1 minus r by r whole square, that is equal to 2 into 1 minus 2 by 6 whole square. This is the answer in meters per second. Hence the problem. The next objective question is, for the same discharge, the power consumed in unit length in laminar flow varies directly as A, due to the power of 4, due to the power of minus 4, due to the power of minus 2, B square. The solution to this problem could be given like this. Power required to overcome a head H is P is equal to WUH watts, where Q is discharge in a meter cube per second and W is the specific weight. Hence, in laminar flow, the power required to overcome frictional resistance in a pipe of length L and diameter D carrying a discharge Q of a fluid of specific weight W and viscosity mu is P is equal to WQ HF, that is 128 mu Q square into L by pi D to the power of 4, so many watts. Therefore, answer is D to the power of 4 A. So, the power required to maintain the laminar flow through pipes is inversely proportional to the D to the power of 4. So, the answer is D to the power of minus 4. I am sorry. D to the power of minus 4. It is proportional to D to the power of minus 4 or inversely proportional to the D to the power of 4. Answer is A, given that D to the power of minus 4. Hence the problem. Now I shall solve a conventional problem for flow through pipes. Oil is pumped through a 7.5 centimeter diameter pipe 1 kilometer long. The dynamic viscosity of oil is 0.1 Newton second per meter square. A power input of 5.4 kilowatts with an overall efficiency of 60% at the pump is noted. Determine the quantity of oil pumped per minute. Also find the Reynolds number of flow if the relative density of oil is 0.90. The solution to this problem is given like this. Let P is equal to power spent in fluid friction, that is given as 5.4. power input was given with an efficiency of 0.6. therefore the power reaching the fluid is 3.24 kilowatts, which is given as 128 mu Q square L divided by pi D to the power of 4. So in overcoming the head loss due to friction or to maintain the flow against the friction, the power spent is 128 mu Q square L by pi D to the power of 4. Therefore, 3240 watts is equal to 128 mu is given as 0.1 Pascal second, Q square is the square of the discharge into 1000, that is 1 kilometer means 1000 meters into pi, diameter is given as 7.5 centimeters, that is 0.075 meters to the power of 4, implies Q square is equal to into 10 power minus 5, Q is equal to 0.00502 meter cube per second, that comes to 301.2 into liters per minute, because 1000 liters is equal to 1 meter cube. That is answer. Therefore, velocity of flow V is equal to discharge divided by pi by 4 d square, that is 0.00502 divided by pi by 4 into 0.075 whole square, it comes to 1.136 meters per second. Reynolds number is equal to Re is equal to Vd rho by mu, comes to 1.136 into diameter is 0.075 into 0.90 into 998 divided by 0.10. It comes to 765 Reynolds number, which is very much a laminar flow. As long as the Reynolds number is less than 2000, the flow is laminar. Hence the problem. Next problem, what I consider is two tanks containing an oil of rho is equal to 950 kg per meter cube and mu is equal to 8 into 10 power minus 2 Pascal second are connected by a 15 centimeter diameter pipeline of length 200 meters. Calculate the maximum difference in the elevation in the oil surfaces that can exist while maintaining laminar flow in the pipe. Solution: the maximum Reynolds number is equal to Re critical. As long as the Reynolds number is less than 2000, the flow is laminar. Therefore, V is equal to 2000 into 8 into 10 power minus 2 divided by 950 into 1 by 0.15. Dynamic viscosity divided by density, that gives the kinematic viscosity, that comes to 1.123 meters per second. Therefore, head loss HF is equal to 32 mu V L by W d square. 32 into 8 into 10 power minus 2, velocity is 1.123 into length is 200 meters, 950 into 9.81, that is W into D is 0.15 whole square. W is rho g. Specific weight is density, mass density into acceleration due to gravity. 2.742 meters. This is the maximum difference in oil surface elevations. Hence the problem. So the head loss due to friction would be the level difference in the two oil reservoirs.